probably kill it this time. There you go. Ah. I was checking the others too to make sure it wasn't another anti-magic area or something. The moss before you is glowing with a strange light. Really? As you touch the moss, electrifying energy flows through your body. You feel recharged with new power. Oh, healing us? Ooh. Okay, we didn't... If we got healed, I didn't notice the bars go up. Our attributes might have gone up. Did they go up, though? That's the question. Tell you what I'm gonna do. Save the screenshot. Okay. I'm not gonna be messing around on my desktop. I'm gonna stop this for a second. Okay, so now we go load this one. Wait a second. Not on the right screen. I'm still not in the... wait. Ah, I took a screenshot of the wrong... damn it. What's wrong with me? Okay. Okay, we go load. I know I could do it the other way too. Alright, so... just not going to. Bear with me, guys. I really don't know what the hell I'm doing. Screenshot 2. Okay, so we'll finally have this right. And this is all I wanted to do. Look at that. Okay. Strength went up by 2. 29, 51, 51, 48, 1, 7, 1, 75, 0, 0s, 3, 45, 0, 20, 20. 95, 20, 15, 0. See, I could look at all of them. I'm just looking for me. Strength went up from 51 to 60. Pretty cool. Okay. Oh my. We're gonna turn to stone, are we? On the base of the statue, you can see in large green runes something. Well, this is short, so... what does it say? I need to be able to see the whole thing. I'd pull in here otherwise. S... A The Y is a... What is it? N... Sanar... And that's a bracket thing is a... where is the bracket? Oh, wait, no. That's an S. Oh, it says Sansri. S-A-N. Alright, that's an S. A. N. S. R. I. So it's Sansri, okay? Not surprising that it would say that. Large green runes. She said, ouch. What is this? You are standing before a chest of petrified wood. Really? Can we open a chest made out of petrified wood? We found a trap and disarmed it. I have opened a lock. In this chest, you find a large quantity of gold and a few objects. We did find a large quantity of gold and another lockpick. Lockpick. We know who gets that. A rope. A whip. A globe of Heract. A bi-handed sword, a brooch of water walk, and another lockpick. Bi-handed sword, Globe of Heract. That's awesome. Oh, you can't carry that. We will take all the gold. It looked like she moved forward, blocking the way out, didn't it? It looked like she's standing right in our way. Alright, so... I would like to identify some of these things. And not sleep instead, or rest. Identification. What about this? Bi-handed sword. It says damage zero. It's cursed! Damn you! Let me guess, we can't put it down. I got rid of it. Okay, cursed. Alright. So, the one we got rid of, let me just double check. I still have Fire Basher. I still have Scimitar. Okay. I know I was wielding Scimitar, just double checking. So identification. I guess because he didn't equip it. Which I thought it was... if it was just in inventory. So now I have three coils of rope. They're pretty heavy too. I might just sell one. Unless the rope is magical. What does this do? Globe of Heract. Magic item. Casts light 3, 100 charges. Alright, sweet. I think I'm gonna officially stop actually using torches. Because now we have this thing, which has 100 charges. We have Satine to cast it. And we also have this Wand of Light. which anyone can use this as well. That has 24 charges of light 3. So might as well. Yeah. Might as well get rid of torches. I'll just let them run out and then that's it. Alright, so... I'm guessing the rope is not magical because you just stack with the other rope. It's reasonable to assume. So we have a whip. Oh, we have this brooch of water walk. Is this a current? We can see if it grants any kind of AC bonus. It does not. Obviously, we can walk on water, or swim, or swimming becomes max to the roof, or something like that. I do want to identify it, so but probably another time. This is the crystal ball. That is not magical. Alright. So I get to identify one more thing. I want to identify the whip. Because we know the other thing's magical. We have a pretty good idea of what it does. The whip, we don't know. It just might be a regular whip. It might be something really special. Apparently just a whip. Yeah, the weapon. Yeah, just a whip. Alright. Pardon me? I'd love to identify that last thing. But we'll have to do that another time. The moss before you is glowing with a strange light. Okay. Should I do it again? Just look at Droba this time. Alright, I hit alt print screen. I guess that didn't work. As you come close to the moss, a strange force flows into your body. Shortly afterwards, you feel as if your thoughts have wings and your knowledge has been extended. Okay, I guess intelligence. Alright, so hold on 1 second. Let me retrieve that screenshot. You see, this one would be intelligence. Oh, he was really low intelligence. Okay. So intelligence here went up 3 points. This is before, this is after. Let me just check everything else. 17, 47, 86, 32, 82, 20. So his strength is 88 out of 90. That's pretty awesome. So that was our previous level up, 66, 25. You'd think there might be, you know, some increase with this stuff that might rely on intelligence, but no. 95, 80, 95, 50, 20, 10, 15, 20, 10, 15, 20, zeros. Alright. Looks like, yeah, strength went up by 3 for the first one. Intelligence went up by 3 for the second. So now Amethyst has intelligence 57 out of 60. And there, 41. Well, I am more intelligent than Trazric. I like that. You generally think of as... Look at that. She's over her max, actually. You tend to think of elves as being, you know, more intelligent than humans. But am I? I'm a human, yeah. So Satine is 63. Past her limit. with intelligence. And as far as strength, I'm pretty strong for freaking a wizard. 53, 62. He's over his strength limit. 71. I wonder if that helps with his bow. It would normally be dexterity, but I wonder if it'd help with the damage with his ranged attacks. Who's this? Greban? 71 out of 60 strength. Well, he's taken a few of the mushrooms as well. I forget. There's blue and red. One of them increases the speed, so you attack earlier in combat. I would have gave more of that to my mage if I had thought of it. Or myself, rather. Because I can heal quicker, saving somebody before the enemy attacks again. That kind of thing. But, you know, hindsight's 20/20. But yeah, the other one increased strength, so that's why we're 71 out of 60 here. Droba, 88 out of 90. Alright, awesome. Now, unfortunately, though, I still have to find my way into this last area, and into here. And I tested all these, trying to see if I can get through. Can't get to the end of that corridor to map it out. I got to find a way in there. Ouch. I think we should rest again. Did he hurt? Yeah, quite a bit. So I'm gonna rest a little bit and I'm gonna identify that brooch. I moved it, didn't I? I moved it to Satine. Approach of water walk. Swimming. It makes swimming 95. Alright. Or plus 95. So I'm thinking give it to Droba. Swimming 70. 80. Greban's maxed out already. 72. 95. She's fine. 52. Yeah, so does he have a brooch? He doesn't have a brooch. So give him the brooch. Boing. No dropping. So his swimming is now maxed out. He is a master swimmer, especially for a dwarf. So I can stop dumping points into that. I don't know what else to dump points into, though. Maybe just search? I mean, for him, or I might just swap it to somebody else. See if I can get him up anyway. 45. Listen. Search can go up to 20. That's it. Obviously, I'm not going to have him finding traps and stuff. I guess his parry I can put up. Yeah, I don't know. Okay. That's what I wanted to do. Gonna rest some more, and I'll see you guys at the end of that. Okay, rested up and took the liberty of coming all the way back here so you guys won't be bored out of your mind. You've seen me traipse back and forth around this dungeon probably too much. So I'm over here. This section is the one that really, you know, irritates me. I didn't have much problem, to tell you the truth, this time. So I find if you click on the wait thing, sometimes a you know, passage will open then. So in any case, I didn't not bothering until now with the spells. That's not formation, but rather spells. We did not encounter anything, so it's all good. What she have? Light? Light 2. She only has 11 casts. She doesn't have light 3. I mean, of course, I'm going to be using the two items, the Wand of Light and the Globe of Haract, if I'm pronouncing that right. I'll be using that before I ever have her use her mana. Unless, you know, these guys are people holding it are paralyzed or something. Or dead, you never know. So that opens something. I'm guessing it's this, because we've got a way in. We just have to find our way through the stone, apparently. Just gonna quickly save here. Hoping we get somewhere. Ooh! Okay, where are we now? We are there. Is it gonna open up again? Oh, I think this is the way, isn't it? Nope, the other way. Exciting. You hear hissing, and very quickly the air is filled with bluish gas. Oh, I just did say that. It means we're held, right? Paralyzation? Or... stunned. I think that's stunned. So... oh, we've got a magic mouth. What is the word? Grease? No. Serpents. Not on the list here, but I'm pretty sure that is it. Come in, for Sansri is expecting you. Huh. You're missing the malevolent laughing at the end. Oh, he opens up. Okay. This is a dead end. I know we need to relieve our held status. Okay, so we'll be going in there. Got it. You're gonna fight Sansri herself? That's pretty exciting. So before we do any of that, let us use the drop. Does Anyone else have this dropping herb? Oh, he has three of them. He has four. Luckily enough, we have one character who is not bound by it. I'm not giving. I'm using. Paralysis. Okay, good. So instead of wasting three more, I think I have a spell for it. Depetrification. Oh, that doesn't do it? It's heal stun, isn't it? Heal stun? Heal stun. Oh, luckily we have... It's a much less mana cost. Teamwork, baby. Teamwork. Okay. Now, good time to save. It appears you're in the innermost part of the temple. The only thing you hear here is the crackling of the torches and the gentle laughter of a woman. Well, at least she's gentle, you know. It's important. Can't take any of these torches. No secret lever or anything like that. I love this theme. It's nice hearing a more energetic theme than the doom and gloom one we've had for like the last 3 hours or something. When the stairs up. Alright, there's nothing. Not sure if that is stairs. As you enter the corridor, you see a few winged serpents and a hissing woman's voice says, I welcome you. I am sorry that we cannot meet personally. I believe my darlings are hungry. Well, I think I'm going to chow down on them instead. Anything? Just want to look at that. Okay. Attack. Alright, quite a bunch. We'll destroy them. Once they line up, I will throw some ice balls. Changing a location. One already. Alright, hold on a second, guys. Okay. So I wonder if we're gonna meet up with her once we kill her darlings. Shall see. It'd be kind of disappointing if we didn't. So apparently she was good, decided to turn to evil and help Lyramion. Really, want to help someone like a name like Lyramion? Sounds. Another ice ball. Ow, that's 23 points on Jovenir. As usual, he can solo what everyone else attacks as a team. And he pretty much keeps up with that. What do you think? One more ice ball? Do I choose ice ball? Which monster? Okay. It looked weird the way it came up. I don't know how to explain it. So he's attacking that, we're attacking that, she's attacking that. Spell. Mm-hmm. Sweet. Now he might be able to chime in here. Still not full. But I think he's good enough. What about Droba? I think Droba is good enough too. I'm gonna save Trazric's mana. Because I'm sure we are fighting more of these things. And then there was one. This one's gonna be damaged from the ice ball. Ice balls, plural. Hooray! 50 experience. Well, yep. Okay, something really unfortunate, but I'm gonna try to roll with it. Once we use up all the charges on an item, like a weapon, it disappears. So, the Fire Basher is gone. Hopefully I didn't screw myself. I mean, I could always restore and fight that battle over, or the two battles over, but I'm gonna keep it real. He's going to be using the scimitar. Too bad that bi-handed sword was cursed. Does zero damage, but I'm thinking, you know, soon we'll find another sword. So, maybe it's a magical sword we can pick up from a merchant. I doubt it, though. So, such is life. Well, now we have more room to carry other stuff. So there's that. Now we've got foreboding-looking doors in the middle here. That is another thing to harm us. Apparently we have to go in there. What happened? I looked at myself. I think I just looked at... If you look at your own character... Yeah, okay. I thought something was about to happen. So that's just another door, so that's not stairs. Alright. On the floor, you see a design made of precious stones depicting a snake. Are you afraid, narrator? Of precious stones depicting a snake! Yes. It's not damaging us, apparently, at this point. Wondering if... Are we supposed to use the snake ring? Yes. Alright, into the throne room. So this whole place is a throne room. This is just further into the throne room. Just now noticing it says throne room. Oh, hello. As you walk through the door, you enter the throne chamber. At the center of the chamber, you see Sansri seated on her throne. Slowly she turns her head to you and says, "You are truly astonishing. I must admit that. I should have listened to Marmion when he told me that you could be dangerous." Oh, you are in league with Marmion. So, prepare yourselves and come forward. I believe you will become the best pieces in my collection. Guess again, Bonky.